What's up, Market Family? Welcome back to my channel. So today I have some Dollar Tree kitchen DIYs to share with you. Before we begin, please let me know, do you want to continue seeing DIY videos on this channel? Lately, DIYs have not been performing well on my channel. I don't know if it's YouTube saying people don't want to see this, so they don't put my videos out there. So please, leave a comment down below. Give the video a thumbs up. Watch it as long as you can to help boost the video, and also give me some feedback on what direction to take this channel. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoy the video. Now let's begin. For this project, you're gonna need a planter from Dollar Tree, and I really like this galvanized planter. I printed out this image of a scale. I got it from craftbits.com. I will link the blog down below for you all. I resized the image to fit my scale, and then I go ahead and cut that out. I'm going to be gluing this to a piece of wood that I got from Dollar Tree, but first I have to paint the wood gray so that it matches the planter. I've done this DIY once before, but please know I wasn't the original creator behind this DIY. It's Jay Money. I've said it before, Jay is hands down one of the most talented crafters in the Dollar Tree community, with so many original crafts that have been recreated so many times. I will have Jay's channel linked down below for you guys. So I'm gonna glue my wooden piece to the front of my planter, and then I'm going to glue the picture of the scale on top of the wood piece. I got a silver charger from Dollar Tree, and I'm gonna glue that to the planter. I recommend using a heavy duty glue like super glue or E6000. However, I'm just using hot glue because I'm pregnant. I don't wanna smell that stuff. Now I have this decorative fake shelf that is perfect for holding fruits or vegetables inside of your kitchen. You can also use this as just a decorative piece, and it can hold so much more than just that. It's all up to you. And what's crazy is this shelf cost me under $4 to make. For our next project, you're gonna need the organizing tool hanger from Dollar Tree, and you're gonna cut it into two separate pieces. You can also get the white one, which is for broom and mop holders. There's an adhesive on the back of that one. There is not on this one, so I'm going to be using some command strips so that I can place this on my wall. Now, I got a broom stick from Dollar Tree. I removed the top off of it, and I pushed that through the broom and mop holder. Now, this DIY is inspired by Paige Did What on TikTok, and I will link her down below for you guys. I wanted to cover up the ends of my broom stick, so what I did is I actually got these fake eggs from Dollar Tree and I painted them black. I then took a scissor, created a little hole on the bottom of it, and then pushed that through the broomstick. When I originally shared this hack with you guys, I used planters, but we're gonna make this so that it works inside of a kitchen. To do that, I'm gonna be using these wire baskets from Dollar Tree and a long zip tie from Dollar Tree. I'm gonna use the zip tie to attach the baskets to the broomstick. As you pull the zip tie, it's gonna start to push the basket against the wall, and this way you're gonna be able to put things inside of there without the basket tipping over on you. You can use this in your kitchen to hold so many different things. I'm putting fruits inside of this because honestly, that's what I have on hand. It's really great for also holding little snack size things. I mean, there's so many things you can use this for. And I feel like this would be really, really cool and work well inside of a laundry room. For our next project, I'm going to be using the wooden crates from Dollar Tree. I prefer the ones that don't have the wooden slat. I'm going to be gluing two crates right on top of each other, and I'm using a mixture of wood glue and hot glue. Now, I'm going to be doing this 4 times. It's up to you though. You can use as many or as little crates as you like. I'm going to be making 4 rows of these crates and gluing them side by side, again using wood glue and hot glue. I got this 18-inch piece of craft wood from Dollar Tree. I'm going to trim it down so that it fits the width of my 4 crates all laid side by side. I'm gluing that piece of craft wood where the 2 rows of crates meet. So I just put some wood glue there and a little bit of hot glue, and then attach my craft wood. Now you can paint or stain your wood. I'm using a watered down paint to get more of a stained look. This is optional. I got these metal label holders, and I'm going to glue them to the craft wood piece. I really like the way this looks when you do this. Inside of this unit, I'm gonna be putting some seasoning, spices, food, and the little glasses that I'm using, I got at Hobby Lobby, and the labels I'm putting on top of this are actually from Dollar Tree. Oh my gosh, these are just the nicest labels. And they have a bunch of different ones I'm gonna share with you guys soon. But anyhow, I put them on the glasses, put the glasses inside of the crate. I absolutely love this piece. It's inexpensive to make. Obviously, you can put whatever you want inside of there. I just really like using these type of pieces for seasonings, spices, things like granola or oatmeal. I don't know. I just really like the way that these look.
For our next project, I'm going to be using the wooden crates from Dollar Tree. I'm going to be gluing two crates side by side, and I do this 3 times. And then I take some clamps to push them really nice and tight against each other as I wait for the wood glue to dry. Now I'm going to be using 3 of these wood boards from Dollar Tree. I am going to cut them down in an angle. At first, I was going to go with a 90 degree angle. To cut them down, I use a utility knife or razor, and I keep going through it until I get through the wood enough, and then I take scissors to it. But I ended up changing it around to 40 degree angle just because that 90 degree angle was a little too steep. But same thing, you're using your utility knife, go through it, and then use scissors to get through the rest and then snap it off. Now I'm taking the 3 sets of crates that I glued together and I am gluing them to the wood boards in a little bit of an angle. Sorry, I don't know the exact degree that I went with. I was just kind of eyeballing it. So I attached the wood crates to one wood board, and then after that I glue the other wood board to the other side of the crates. For this DIY, I decided to use some screws. I used very small screws to screw between the wood board and the crate. This is not necessary. I decided to do this because every time I do a DIY involving wood, I will get comments about using nails or screws. You can do that. You can do exactly what you want to with any of the DIYs that I make. I give you guys the inspiration and it's up to you to change it around to suit your style, your budget, your needs. So if you ever decide like, no, this needs screws, use them. I decided to do it with this, but it's not necessary. Just don't put anything heavy inside of the crates if you'd plan on just using wood glue. So I did cut down my 3rd wood board to a smaller, to shorter piece, not an angle at all. And I used wood glue and hot glue to glue that to the top where I have that angle and the other 2 pieces of wood board. That way I can make this look like a cute little stand. You can decorate the top of the stand. Dollar Tree has these galvanized pieces. If you bend them in the back, they just hook right on top of the wood there. And then I found this wooden frame piece from Dollar Tree. I don't know if you guys can hear that. That's Cooper singing. I liked the frame look, so I decided to glue that on top of the wood board. This is not necessary. I just like the way that it looked. So I'm just making this cute little stand to hold K-cups and creamers and sugars. Like I said, if you're putting lightweight things inside of this, you can just use wood glue. And this is a perfect example. These things are lightweight. It's not going to fall apart on you. How many K-cups you can hold inside of each crate depends on the angle of the crate. So the angle of the crates at the top were much steeper, so I could only hold 3 K-cups up there. But at the bottom, they weren't as angled, so I could hold 6 K-cups inside of each crate. That's something to think about if you want this to hold a lot more K-cups. You want to go with an angle that's not as sharp as the top ones on mine. On the top of this, I decided to take a paint pen and write out coffee bar, open 24 hours, and then I drew a little bit of like a fabric type of situation at the top to make it look super cute. You can always do like your last name, I don't know, the Sanchez's coffee bar open 24 hours. I think that'd be a cute idea as well. And obviously this does not have to be just for coffee. It could be a decoration piece. You can put sweets inside of this. There's other options beside coffee. If you want something that holds a lot more K-cups, try this DIY. A couple of years ago, I made this K-cup holder using the Dollar Tree wire basket. In short, you get a wire basket from Dollar Tree. You bend the bottom to mold it into the shape of a cup, and then you can find something at Dollar Tree to create the hook for this. Now, in that original video, I used a garden fence from Dollar Tree, and a lot of people said they had a hard time cutting the garden fence. So this time around, I'm going to use the garden hooks from Dollar Tree. They come 2 for a dollar. All you have to do is zip tie them to your basket. In that original video, I gave credit to Teresa Beatty for this idea. However, since that video, I have found somebody who uploaded this DIY even sooner, and that's Crafty Decoria here on YouTube. I try my best to give credit when credit is due. I usually credit the person I've seen do a DIY, but that doesn't mean they're always the original creator behind something. It's very hard to tell on the internet who the original creator of things are, just because so many people are inspired by others and lots of times credit isn't given, so the original creator gets lost in everything. So I try my best Doesn't mean it's always perfect. Now I'm using the circle chalkboard tags from Dollar Tree. I'm going to take a chalk marker and write K-cups on the front of this. And then I'm going to glue that to the front of the wire basket. Now I decided to make a little creamer for this. So basically you're going to get another wire basket, but you're going to get one of these smaller ones that Dollar Tree carries. You're going to bend around one of the sides to make it look like a spout. For the handle of my creamer, I'm going to be using this sign from Dollar Tree. I removed the hook off of it and I put that on the side of the wire basket to be the handle. I needed something smaller because the plant hanger from Dollar Tree is just way too big. And then I went ahead and I just glued on the sign that says creamer. I ended up cutting it down a bit because it was just too big at first. That's how you make these super easy cake cup and creamer holders. They're so easy to make, you guys, and they're super inexpensive too. This is an oldie but a goodie. Get the plant hangers from Dollar Tree. To attach this to my wall, I'm using some command strips. I'm using two on the back of each plant hanger. I actually recommend screwing these into your wall. They do come with screws. If you're using just command strips like me, you cannot put too much weight on your shelves. For my shelves, I'm going to be using these DIY wood boards from Dollar Tree. Three of them total to get a thicker piece. Now you can glue them together. I'm not doing that because this is not actually staying inside of my kitchen. My kitchen's too tiny, so in order for me to do DIYs for you guys inside of there, I do have to remove ones that I make. There are different parts of the plant hanger that you can actually hang a wooden dowel off of, or the wooden piece of a toilet plunger from Dollar Tree, and then you can hang things off of that wooden piece. So I'm using a wooden dowel I got for 99 cents at Walmart, and then I'm just hanging some kitchen towels off of that. Now I decided to paint the sides of the wooden plank black just to make it blend in more nicely, but that's how you make a really easy shelf using Dollar Tree products. Like I said, I recommend using the screws to screw the plant hangers into your wall, but sometimes that's just not an option. I've done a DIY like this before using command strips on the back of the plant hangers. I'll make sure to link it down below for you guys. I had that DIY up for 3 months with no issue. Again, as long as you're not putting a lot of weight on the shelf, you can get away with just command strips, but I recommend the name brand command strips. I have an easy hack for the paper towel holders from Dollar Tree. If you know anything about those paper towel holders, you know that when you take a paper towel off, the entire thing moves. So an easy hack is to get out your hot glue gun and put hot glue on the bottom of the paper towel holder. Cover the entire thing in hot glue. Wait for the hot glue to completely dry and then just place it down wherever you want. The hot glue is going to act as a rubber, which is going to keep the paper towel holder in place. You can also glue the Dollar Tree non-slip shelf liner to the bottom of the paper towel holder and do it that way instead. Now this paper towel holder is pretty boring, so a way to spruce it up without breaking the bank is just to get one of the burlap canvases from Dollar Tree. Place the paper towel holder on top of the canvas and then use zip ties to attach the paper towel holder to the burlap. And the reason I'm using zip ties is because I don't want to hot glue this to the burlap. If I hot glue it, there's a good chance it's gonna fall right off because the burlap has so many gaps for the glue to fall down. And also I don't want to put it underneath the burlap because if I do that, then the paper towels are gonna keep sticking to the burlap, which is gonna make it hard to roll it out. It's real easy to push the zip ties through the burlap. You don't need a scissor or anything to do it. Make sure you put some hot glue on the bottom of the canvas so it isn't sliding around on you. That's how you just elevate your paper towel holder just a little bit without breaking the bank. Because if you're going to be spending so much on trying to decorate the paper towel holder, you might as well just go buy one already done.
Dollar Tree carries so many glass jars and containers that are perfect for storing food, seasoning, and spices. And you can pair them right now with the labels Dollar Tree has in. I told you guys there are three packs. I just shared with you guys one of the packs. Now the second pack has more of a redone font, and all of these labels are pre-made. You can't customize them at all. And I really do like this pack. Now the third pack that they do have some labels that you can customize. So if you don't have the ingredient or the food that you want to label the container with, you take the chalk marker and just write over one of the blank labels. My favorite though is the first one I shared with you guys. However, that one you get the least bang for your buck. For this project, I'm going to be using two of these frame boards from Dollar Tree as well as these wood planks from Dollar Tree. Now I'm going to be gluing three of the wood planks to one of the wood boards. I did one at the top, one in the middle, and one at the bottom.
I then go ahead and glue on my other wood board. Now I decided to use some screws inside of the middle shelf and the top shelf. Reason being, hot glue alone is not going to cut it here if I'm going to be placing heavy things on top of the shelves. If you're using just lightweight things or placing lightweight things on top of these shelves, you're going to be okay, but any sort of weight, if you're just using hot glue alone, is not going to cut it. The only shelf you can put heavy things on top of if you used hot glue is the bottom shelf. Now I'm going to go ahead in with a white paint, and I decided to paint the front of my shelves. I do wish, however, before I glued on those wooden boards, I would have painted the inside, or I guess the back of them, white. Now put whatever you want on top of your shelves. I have it holding some spices. In the middle shelf, I decided to put a little plant. Doesn't have to be this. I feel like this would hold like fruit snack boxes and snack boxes like chewy granola bars really, really well. This was super easy to make. I only needed 5 Dollar Tree products to make this. And if you don't want to go somewhere else to buy screws, you can find them at Dollar Tree. For this DIY, I'm going to be using this wooden tray I got at Dollar Tree for $3. I finally have a Dollar Tree Plus, and I'm also going to be using this Lazy Susan hardware. I paid under $5 for it. If you have just a regular Dollar Tree, you could get 3 of the wood hanging decor pieces and glue them together. This is a size comparison between the two. Now what I'm doing is I'm taking the Lazy Susan hardware and I am going to glue that to the bottom of my wood tray. And I just use hot glue. This is perfectly fine to use. You can use wood glue. Glue alone is going to do the trick. You don't need screws. But I decided to share with you guys how this works with screws. The wood of this is so thin that if you use screws, it just goes right through the tray. And I used the smallest screws that I own and they went through the tray. So I ended up having to use some hot glue to cover up the screw so that I wouldn't have these sharp things sticking out. So just use glue. It's going to work just fine for a Lazy Susan. Now go ahead and paint your wood. I just used a watered down brown paint, so I got a little bit more of a stain. The main reason I decided to go with this tray is because of the size of it. If I would have went with the hanging decor pieces, it wouldn't fit inside of this particular cabinet of mine. So I have my Lazy Susan down. I fill it up with some of the products that were already sitting inside of my cabinet. And now I have this Lazy Susan to just spin around everything and see everything more clearly versus having to dig through the cabinet. Now I do have some oils that didn't fit on this Lazy Susan, so I moved the Lazy Susan to the side and I placed them right beside the Lazy Susan. I'm just trying to share with you guys to be more transparent. I've shared this DIY before, but it was actually in a bathroom DIY video. I'm going to reshare it in this video because it works well inside of the kitchen. What you're going to do is you're going to get the step shelf from Dollar Tree, as well as their wicker baskets, the ones that are the rectangular shape and a little bit deeper. What you're going to do is you're going to use some zip ties from Dollar Tree to attach these wicker baskets to the step shelf. And you automatically make a piece that you can use to organize underneath your kitchen sink, or you can even use as a tier tray to put vegetables and fruits inside of. And obviously, not just vegetables, fruits, you can put whatever you want inside of there. That's just the first thing that comes to my mind. This DIY is a decorative piece. You can get the bamboo utensils from Dollar Tree and then paint them if you want. I decided to paint mine all black. Now get some lightweight plates from Dollar Tree. I went with this 2-pack that's $1.25 for 2. Lightweight and they're plastic. So what I'm going to do is I am going to take some poster stickers from Dollar Tree, alphabet ones, and I'm just going to spell out eat on top of the plate. I start with the A because that's the center letter. If I figure out the center letter, I can make sure that it's centered on the plate and then work my way outward. Around the plate, I'm just going to stipple on some black paint to give it that enamel type of rustic look. Next up, I got the rulers from Dollar Tree, the wood rulers. They come 2 for $1.25. The part that has the inches and all of that on there, it's like a sticker. You can go ahead and remove that. Now I decided to stain the wood of this a dark walnut color. It's a dark walnut by Minwax. Now I used wood glue to attach 2 rulers together. I did this 4 times, so I have 4 different sets like this. And these sets are going to be the background of the image that I'm making. And then I'm going to take 2 rulers and I'm going to glue them on the sides of those 4 sets to make 1 image that's all stuck together. Finally, I glue the utensils and plate down. I used my wood glue to glue those 2 the wood. I just felt like it would hold better than just using hot glue alone. Since making this DIY, Dollar Tree carries longer pieces of craft wood that you can use instead of the rulers from Dollar Tree, or you can even go to the hardware store and just get a big piece for a very inexpensive price. But that's how I made this eat decor piece that is perfect for a farmhouse theme kitchen.
So that's it for the video. Again, let me know, do you want to see more DIY videos? Do you want to see more come with me's? I need your guys' suggestions down in the comments below. I will see you next time. Take care. Bye.